and called it version. Right, I'm trying to see. Right, okay, so this is the Friday night living room session. We're going to do some little fun and games and experiments in a minute. It's just gone 11 o'clock, 3rd of March 2017. I'm in the living room, as you can see. Oh, I've got a cold spot right next to me. This don't need to be turned on while I'm in here, so that can go down on the floor. Got a crucifix here. Mobile, got to do an EVP first after I've had a drop of my coffee. Can't hear myself at the moment, so I'm going to turn the volume up on here for a second just to see if the audio is still working. Yep. Right. Rose. Something fell down. Could have been a battery, I don't know, because there are lots of batteries here, but they're all sturdy. So thank you for doing that. That was a spirit. Well, I'm going to do quick EVP. Rose, I think it'd be okay for me to tell you, she has been going to hospitals for checkups. She's not feel at all well at the moment, and that's mainly, I think, due to all the shit that's going on, all this fucking hate, bullshit, drama, crap that's making her worse. So you guys need to fucking leave her alone and stop causing so much shit, making people ill. We would like it if it fucking happened to you. Alright, okay, calm down, Steve. But Rose is a good friend of mine, and she don't deserve this shit. No one deserves the shit that we keep getting. Right. Okay, guys. I'll put this down here. Right. Anyone in here want to say hello? Can you say hello by saying your name? Is there anyone in here going to talk to me tonight? If so, again, tell me the name of the spirit who's going to talk to me. Am I protected tonight? Yes or no? How many spirits want to talk to me tonight on the Ouija board? It's like some drawing down the back of my back. Like, you know, scratching. Are we in need to talk to Molly at some stage? Do you know, guys, she needs to talk to me yet? If so, how about next weekend? How would you feel me bringing Molly in here and letting her be with you lot. Would you like that? Yes or no? Are you going to give me any kind of activity in here tonight, guys? Yes or no? I hope you will. I hope you set off some of the devices at least. Or throw the ball down, which I had a minute ago. That's disappeared. I had a ball here and it's gone. And I've got one here. Can I put this one here? And that's right, you know. That can't be knocked down unless it's pushed down. Can you tell me what kind of shape that is? What kind of shape is it? Can you tell me what kind of object this is? They used during the World War II mostly and Vietnam. What is this object? What's it shaped as? Do you know what the make of the actual item is? Do you know what its name is? So, can you say its name? And have you got anything you want to tell me? Any kind of message? So, I'm going to give you about 20 seconds. For one of you to give me that message now. Okay, thank you. Well, I'll play that back in a minute. Notice that the K2 meter here isn't facing around properly. So I nearly finished my coffee. Let me just finish this off. Over there, because that don't work. There's one thing I need. One thing I need to get before I start. Actually, I can take my cup out and I'll take that camcorder back in the bedroom, the non-working one. Get things sorted out quickly. over and get in your bed. Move. I'll trip over you, okay? Because there's no light in here. Kick up the back side.
Right. Right, play back the EVP. I don't feel it like overwhelming with energy in here like I have done sometimes. I thought it's a little bit quiet at the moment. Yes, Steve. I can hear you. Yes, Steve.
Tonight, yes or no?
What? Yes, Steve.
Am I protected tonight, yes or no? Am I protected tonight, yes or no?
I hear yes, Steve, but you might not be able to hear it, but I can hear it. Now the thing is, I did not bring in my pen and paper, so I've got nowhere to put it. My back's gone really cold now.
Sounds
like looking. Now, oh, I was actually looking for the ball, and there's a female going, looking. Looking, you can hear it, looking. Yeah, looking. I'll put it back on a minute. Right, it's about half, just over halfway.
Is it? during the World War II mostly, and Vietnam. What is this object? What is it shaped as? Do you know what the make of the actual item is? Do you know what its name is? So can you say its name?
I can like hear little whispers, but so quiet. It's not even worth playing the back because I can hardly understand what it's saying anyway.
And have you got anything you want to tell me? Any kind of message? If so, I'm going to give you about 20 seconds. But wanting you to give me that message now.
Well, my YouTube's really gone slow. I just saw myself sitting in the living room, moving around. Not in here.
No, thank you.
Right, okay, so there's not much on that one. Let me just sort that in YouTube. I am still live, aren't I? Still alive. What's happening now? I think I'm still alive. Well, I've got a couple of things I'm going to do. I'm going to move this for one. Move that out of the way. My fucking arm and leg back. Oh, oh God. Oh, should we use the chair? Next thing I'm going to try and make sure that this is still working. That's working. Right, I can't play the guitar. Well, I'm gonna have a little cut the drums on it. And maybe you spirits might come through later. And strum it for me. I wish I was like Simon James, who could sing and dance. They'd probably come out and fucking start throwing things at me. Shut up, Steve, you're too noisy, we don't like it. So if you want to come and strum this later, feel free to. Got this from a charity shop for £5. It's definitely out of tune though. think it's raining on that side. You know what I'd like to have got? A banjo.
When I'm cleaning windows.
That'd be good, wouldn't it, eh? Right, so you want to come and strum this. You know how to do it. That'd be cool. I'm going to stick the old ghosty box on for 5-10 minutes. And then we'll do a Ouija board. Turn it down a little bit. Hello? Actually, I can't hear it now. Anyone around? I thought it said Rodney then. Rodney? What kind of doll is this? Do you know what it is? She's a certain doll that's meant to be like a fish. What do they call half female and half fish? That swim in the sea. Do you know? There's a ghost box vibrating it, just set me off. Oh shit, the battery's come out. I was going to put that on. I've got another one, I'll go and get another one. I don't know if you can see that there, that's actually flashing. Can you spirit see that? What's it doing, that glass? Oh, I'm going to go bathroom again quickly before I do the weed, start the weed ball. fellow over there went really bright red just then and stopped. My back keeps going cold. Why is he bright red? That horse and him is bright red. Them two are bright red, and these are like, you know, the other ones are kind of like white. Now I'm getting fluctuation in heat temperatures in here, but nothing major, maybe. I wonder what it's like with the light off, if I can see the weak bulb properly. No, I can't. Can't see it all that well. Can you say Ouija board on the ghost box? Right, got a ball there, and this ball here. They can't fall down unless something physically moves them. Time is it? Oh, it's gone cold in here again. Right, a couple more minutes, then we'll start the weave on. Which is a knock on the door. I don't know that's me. Where is the cat? Now Susie just heard, right? I seriously, honestly just heard if someone was at my door going. It was like three knocks. Okay, no, I don't think the cat can knock three times on the door. So, I'm going to put that on his head, because you can't really see it now. It's getting really cold in here though. Right, Melmix says 0.5. I know you can't see it that well because the Ouija board's in the way. But you'll hear it if it goes off. And if this goes off, you'll probably hear it. Actually, I'll put that on her head. Pretend you're Indian. Right, I did do a prayer in the bathroom earlier, but I'm going to do a quick one again. Actually, that might kind of keep going off. It's going to keep going off. Right, again, Heavenly Father, God, protect me while to do this Ouija board session. Keep all evil, negative, demonic spirits away from me. Only allow the good, kind, loving ones to come through. I don't mind mischievous little buggers, as long as they're not harmful. I don't mind coming through and mucking around the devices and knocking a few things down and just giving us general activity. But I ask you to guide and protect us from any evil spirits, ghosts, entities, demonic spirits, evil witches, warlocks, or anything evil and non-visible to my eyes, or anything that I may not feel around me, must not come and cause me any harm. So I ask you to guide and protect me and surround me love and light and lots of protection, and I ask you to protect me and the cat. Yes, I ask in your holy name. Amen. Right, right there. Put that there. Still a bit high now. A bit high. Still, I don't know. If I do it that way, it's going to be too low. That's still a little bit too high. Don't have a box smaller than that. No one's too heavy for me to pick up. I'll have to do it as it is. Right, I'll move this over here. Right, okay. Here we go. Ouija. Right, I invite those spirits who wish to come through and communicate with me. Hello, good evening, good morning, or afternoon, or whatever time is in the spirit world. Hello. Does anyone want to come and say hello to me? Session in here tonight. We will do our best to make some activity for you, but can't as the weather conditions are making it hard for us to do any think and as it is I am being helped by Tina and Dougie and Debbie, so don't expect too much from us today. Love. Okay. Yeah, well, whatever you can do, yeah, it's fine by me. You know, if you can set at least 1 or 2K, 2 meters or something, that'd be fine. If you can't, then you can't, you know. Is there anyone who wants to talk to us tonight? No.
because of the weather. Conditions. Holding us back. Okay.
So I'm thinking of like bringing out Molly next weekend. What do you think on that?
Oh, no. Not evil Molly. Again. Laugh out loud.
Well, she's been stuck in the box for a couple of weeks now, and she does say that, you know, she's got some other so-called dark secrets to tell us. So, you know, maybe giving her a little break from that dark box in the dark cupboard in the kitchen. She might come out and talk to us. And, you know, I was able to handle it last time, so I'm pretty sure I'll be able to handle it next time. So what do you reckon?
Okay. Up to you. We will be ready to step in. Needed.
Okay, that's fair enough. Actually, a quick question from my dad. Jessica wants to know, did any of you guys go over there when she had Jessam?
We all went to say hi to Jessam.
Steve. What, all, every single one of you like 100 spirits plus?
No. Not that bad. Just me and Tina and Dougie, okay. And some others went to family members. Mostly.
What, Ronald? Kevin and Reggie?
Just Reggie. Kevin was not around. Okay. Who else Eddie, yeah. And Pam and also Tina. The younger one.
Oh, okay. So, he's already been giggling. Don't know if he saw the video the other day.
Unless it was fun. to see him smile. Maybe it was wind. Oh yeah, true, wind from feeding, yeah. Babies do giggle, make weird faces when they get wind, when they've had their drink or feed.
How would you like me to bring Molly in here from there on and let her to be with you guys?
Don't. You. Fucking. There. Or I. Will. Leave. You. For. Good.
No, you won't. Because you love me too much.
Not that they're true. But I don't like evil arse. Spirits like Molly to be in here, so don't even go there.
What, not even if she's still bound and in the box?
No. Not even then.
So, you know, do you think that she'll ever change? So I'm going to have to leave her in that box in the cupboard in the kitchen indefinitely?
Yes. For sure, unless you get rid of her, then that will be the best thing for us all. She can still cause problems even when in the kitchen in that box, so try not to piss her off too much and we'll be okay.
Then, has she caused any problems since I put her back in there?
Had a
argument. And that's all really. So keep her away from us, please.
Well, have I got one of those glass kind of like container things and bought me now?
No. Okay.
If I was to put her in a glass container in the kitchen.
No. She can still make problems.
But I thought those glass containers, if you've done it properly, you could like bind them in those glass containers and they can't cause any problems.
Depends on how you do it, but it might not work, so don't bother trying it.
How about if I took in my bedroom for a night and left her unbounded?
No, no, don't do that. Not that loud. She may do naughty things to you.
Bit of fucking fine chance. Right. Okay. So, I've got a headache. Not a headache, I've got a headache all day. And I've got a headache.
That may be just a little stress related thing, so don't worry about that.
Okay, right, have you got any messages or you want to tell me anything?
No.
Okay, does any spirits want to talk to us?
No. Not. Unless you want to give it a try to call someone from the spirit world. Steve the portal is open in the mirror on the try. Okay. And we will stand by in case of any problems. Okay.
Right then. Do what I do, don't I? Do what I don't I? Right, I'll leave. Let you stay on the sideline then. All the spirits in here, stay on the sideline. If you do want to talk to me some other time. I'm going to try and call to see if any spirits want to come through. If I don't get no reply within about 3 or 4 minutes, then I will end the Ouija board session and go back in the living room and do an afterlife ghost box. Now give me a few minutes. Oh, my neck's hurting. My back hurts. Right. Wait a minute, guys. Let's see what's going on here. Right, invite those from the spirit world to come through and communicate with me if anyone wants to come and talk to me. Main Steve, the portal is supposed to be open, so if anyone wants to come through and talk to me, please do so. But you must be of good, kind, hearted spirit, no negative ones. If you're like a bit of a mischievous little bugger, I don't mind, as long as you don't cause too much aggravation. If there ain't none who want to come through and talk to me, maybe some of the spirits in here may try to set off the devices for me if possible. If you can, if you can't, then don't worry. But God, my arm's going really cold. I've got goosebumps. Oh Jesus, my arm's going really ice cold. So anyone wants to come through and talk to me from the spirit world, now's your chance. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to try to come through. If you don't come through in a couple of minutes, then I'm going to just end this. Anyone? Any spirits on another dimension or portal? No one in here for tonight, please. I'll give you a chance to talk to me another night. I want to see if anyone with that mirror wants to come through and talk. First of all, can you tell me your name? Spell out your name by using the alphabet on this board. T. O. H. Is that Thomas? Okay. Otherwise, T-A-T-O-M. Oh, I don't know. Okay, fair enough. What's your surname, Thomas? Thomas Edwards. And how old are you? What was your age when you before you passed away? What was 7? What year did you pass away? Can you tell me what the year? '75. Okay. And you was 43, did you say? '43. Died. 75. Okay, so '43. So you died 75. So around about 1930 you was born. Okay. Where was you born? What town have you come from? Wallington Cemetery. Okay. What kind of work did you do before you died? Done many jobs, but my last job was a green grocer. Got really freezing cold. I actually done that myself when I was younger, going groceries, working in a, I think it was Safeways. A lot of heavy lifting in going grocery, isn't there? What's your best seller on your green grocing? Potatoes, yeah. How about fruit wise? Did you find that many people always dug their goddamn fingernails in like apples and bananas? Yes. And bloody annoying. It ruin the stock and had to throw it away. Making us lose Yeah, I know. The guy who was in charge of me, I can't remember his name, he got kind of a bit pissed off because, like, we had to keep throwing a lot of products away. You know, sometimes we'd bag him up and do, like, a reduction price, but, you know, where people are digging nails in, you don't know what kind of, like, diseases they're carrying around and could, like, cause, like, the people will buy them upset stomachs and stuff like that, so we was, like, very careful on what we could actually reduce. If it was a bruised apple or pear or banana, then we could, like, wrap them up and reduce them, but if it's, like, pierced, then we couldn't do it. And to throw all that away was a waste. Yeah, I know. I know, because I worked there. I was actually in the fruit and veg department for well over 6 months, I think it was. So, yeah, I know. The only thing that kind of, like, whacked me out a little bit, though, was carrying bloody bags of potatoes in time to time. And I had to carry those around when I was in a fish and chip shop. It's very heavy. Bags that caused me many backaches. Yeah, me too, mate. So I know where you're coming from. How many people actually worked with you? Three. Is that three including you or three others? Include, okay. So there's you and two others. Okay. And was this your own shop or was it a market stall or some other place? Store. We had one in Morden as well in the place I mentioned. Okay. So did you have to travel back and forth to work in each one, or was you always at one particular one? Back and forth. So did you have a good, kind of like, loud shouting voice? Yes. What's your favourite shouting out kind of thing? Three boxes of strawberries for a pound. What do you say? Three boxes of strawberries for a pound? Or did you just, like, hold up your strawberry box and say, three boxes for a pound? Or something like that. 3 boxes of strawberries for £1. Okay. You should go train up for a trader. No, thank you very much. The condition I'm in, I've got backaches, I've got headaches, I've got problems with my arm. You know, they will fucking like kick me out before you even like tell them what's wrong with me. So, no, thank you. So, how many years did you do the greengrocers for, the traders? About 5 years. Was that your favourite job, or did you have a different job that you liked? So you liked it. Okay. So, have I ever been to the cemetery around you, do you think? Don't know. Not seen you there. Maybe you might want to visit it one day. Oh yeah, I probably will do. I do a lot of visits around cemeteries and do videos and EVPs and stuff like that. So what do you think about people like me trying to talk to the spirit world, you know, to people we don't know? A bit odd to say the truth, but it is good that you care about the dead and talk to us as if we're still alive and are to be taken serious, to be honest and to tell people that we do still exist, even after our death. So thanks for doing this, mate. That's no problem. Did you hear me calling out for spirits, or did someone bring you through? recording. So I came to say hi. Well, thank you for that. Was there any other spirits who wanted to come through? No. Okay, fair enough. Maybe another night when the weather's a bit better. I've been told by Abby that the weather conditions can affect communication. Yes, for sure, it can. Steve. Okay, mate. So can I just ask you one quick question? You don't have to answer if you don't want to by saying no, but how did you die? I'm a Catholic, so I don't mind saying how I died. I died from a stroke. Steve. Okay, sorry to hear that. Sorry to hear that. Was it just the one stroke or did you have several? Just the one stroke that was bad enough. Okay. Was you married? Did you have any kids? Okay, is your wife still alive? So she's with you on the other side. And is watching us talk. What's your wife's name? Geraldine. Okay, hello Geraldine, if you're watching, welcome. I hope you don't mind me talking to the old man, your husband. It's his own free will to come through, so thank him for coming through anyway. Okay, this is Geraldine talking. And she goes, yeah, that's okay, Steve. You're welcome, honey. Call me honey now. Whoa. So, how old are you, Geraldine? 64. So, do you live longer than Thomas? Okay. How many years was you married? Don't mind me asking. Oh, 24 years, that's long. And what kind of work did you do? Assistant in a bank. Do you know, can you tell me what bank it was? Abby. Okay, that's enough. I know what one you're on about. Better not say the proper name, I might get done for copyright infringements. Yeah, so you was a bank assistant, yeah? Did you actually hand out the cash or did you just assist, like, on queries and complaints. Trash mostly. And where batch did you work? Ask me another. As I can't tell you that. Okay. Quiet him. Do you like cooking? So, I suppose you was able to get free, like, groceries time to time from the old man then when he was at the market, yeah? Oh, yes. And saved a lot of money too. So, what's the favourite Sunday meal did you like to cook? What did Thomas like? No. He loved the roast of... Yeah, well, anyone likes a roast dinner, but, you know, what kind of meat was it? Chicken? Lamb? Turkey? What? Chicken. Mostly. And what kind of veggies did he like? And I am. You'll probably be going and right go at me. Oh, you eat them greens, love. You know, you don't grow a big, stronger boy if you don't eat them greens. Well, I only eat greens like cabbage in a kebab. I don't eat it like on roast dinner. Carrots, I can't stand. Peas, I used to hate, but I love peas now. Broccoli, I cannot stand. I hate that. What else is there? Yeah, I like mostly the salad stuff like lettuce, cucumber, tomato, onions, mushrooms. I hate turnips. I can't eat turnips. So there's like certain stuff I'll eat and some, you know, I am a bit of a fussy eater, to be honest with you, yeah. Certain foods then. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm a fussy eater. Not like my dad, Dougie. He'll eat anything you put in front of him. Probably a bit like Thomas. No, you've given him a plate of food, I'm damn well sure he'd ask for a second, my dad. And be careful, my dad will ask for a kiss. Even if you're our spirit, he will ask for a kiss. So I hope Thomas won't mind you giving him a kiss. Already done that laugh out loud. Yeah, any spirit woman who comes through will ask for a kiss. He's always been like that since he got married to Joan, his second wife. So, thank you for coming through and talking to us. Are you both buried in the same cemetery? Top of each other. Hey, I know what you're thinking. Right, stop it. Put naughty thoughts in my mind. So yeah, anytime I'm trying to, you know, get time to come down that area, I'll pop in and, you know, I may not find your resting place, but I'll come in. And if I remember, say hello to you. I do normally sometimes leave crosses as a token of respect from time to time. If I've got any, I'll leave a few around and, you know, you can all share it, you know, the spirit world or whatever. So is there anything you and Tom want to say before I finish? Spirits here, please. If okay with you, it's okay with me. Just ask Abby. If she says yeah, then it's fine. But Tina will tell you the rules. If you're going to stay around, you know, you're meant to be in here. Can't really be roaming around unless I give permission. And, you know, if you want to knock, tap, bang, you know, sing, laugh, cry, I don't mind that. As long as it ain't over the top. And it's something that you're not going to scare me with. So, yeah, if Abby okays it, then I don't mind. Abby said yes. Thanks for the chat, Steve. We will obey the rules. Abby tells us and we won't scare you too much. Laugh out loud. Thanks. Hey, no worries, take it easy, yeah? Thomas, you okay with that? Thanks, Steve, for me. And we won't out stay now welcome honest so. Right, cheers, Tom. Cheers for that, mate. Thanks for coming through anyway, yeah. Appreciate that. Didn't have to, but you did. So I really do appreciate you coming through and talking. You can stay as long as you like, mate. You know, no one can, like, outstay their welcome. You can stay as long as you bloody like, you know. Even up to the day I die, I don't give a damn, you know. I'll just behave. So, Abby, you okay? I think that was good of them to stop by and say hello. They are very nice people, Steve, so don't worry about them, causing any problems. As I'm very sure they won't. Okay, cool. Just let them know about Molly, yeah? Okay, we'll do. Talk to you later, as I need to rest now. Okay. Yeah, sure. Thanks, Abby, coming through. Any new spirits that come through, yeah, who decides to hang around for a while, just let them know about Molly, okay? Because I don't want them getting affected. Okay, thanks guys for coming through and talking to us. I really got really cold when I was talking to Thomas and his wife, Geraldine. And I had like a real kind of like stonging headache when I was talking to him when he said stroke. That could have been like part of the effect of him having a stroke. Because I know, like I said many times before, you know, spirits do tend to like affect you, not in a evil or negative way, but they can affect you in some way, the way they died. And I don't mean to do that, but it's something that I can't help doing. So, like, you know, I hope they're going to be okay. I don't mind staying around. They probably think I'm living in a bit of a shithole, but never mind, you know, it's my place. And if they want to stay, they can stay. And if they do stay, they need to be good and abide by the rules. So, I'll close this ball with love and light. No spirits can come through and communicate with us at this time. There will not be no more sessions tonight, but there will be probably Monday or Tuesday. So any spirits do want to come through, you'll have to wait until then. Well, this session is now over and done with. So thank you for communicating with us. And this board is now closed. Any doorway, portal opening I've opened is now closed. And this has always been left open. And if it does, and you know, as long as no negative ones come through, then I don't mind. But this session is over and done with. Thank you. Goodbye, 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 and goodbye. Done. Finished. Over and done with. So, I'm going to put this chair back. And I'm going to go back in my bedroom where it's warmer. because it's bloody freezing cold in here. Put that there. Up there. Okay, 2 meter. That can go there. I've not heard this go off. So that can go, turn it off anyway. That and that can come in my room because I do not want that broken. Let's quickly just have a quick scan around. There's a movement over there. I want to bother. Let's see. I want to see if I'll get any kind of heat sink on the mirror itself. Apart from my heat sink. Would have been interesting if there was something that came through. I'm not saying that every kind of portal can bring in some kind of heat sink, but you know, there's a possibility it could do. If I did catch a sight, that would have been cool. Right, okay, so I'm gonna leave those there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Something just went straight through my arm. Oh. I'll leave the laptop on in here for a little while. Camcorder can now be turned off. So I want.
Hey guys, it's me, Steve. It's Sunday the 5th of March 2017 and it's 1:30 PM in the afternoon. Come over to the common to say hello to Adrian Gilbert. Going to his location now. I've got my little head camera, so I'm going to put on in a minute. So this camcorder is going to be a bit wonky for a few seconds. Right guys, Steve here. I thought I might be having some fun, but I didn't. Where Adrian kind of banged himself and Gilbert died in this area 2014. Apparently he took an overdose and probably was laying around here dragging himself around this area. This is the kind of area you said he was on the Ouija board. Don't know where I might drag myself. I put cross and chain over there. Might have saw it on the head cam. Must be terrible to see someone die or find a dead body around here. You see, it's been really raining quite a lot, guys. I'm not going over there, it's just too wet. Whoa. Yeah. Sliding around everywhere. But I'm not staying too long, guys. It's very cold and windy. I'll make tracks over to Fenders of the Water area in the in it. Because I didn't have this camera running at the time. I'll quickly just show you where I put a little crossing chain. I don't think anyone's going to see it from where I put it. I can only barely see it here. So that's a crossing chain for Adrian Gilbert. That's for you, mate. I'm going to quickly try and get me Nookie out. I know it's going to be very hard to do an EVP here because of the daytime traffic contamination. We're going to give it a quick go in this little corner bit. Sorry guys, something went in my mouth. Adrian, if you're here, mate, it's me, Steve. Spoke to you on the Ouija board last week. So I haven't been down here before then, because it's been kind of too lazy, to be honest with you. It's been cold and raining as well. So if you're around, can you shout out hello? Can you even try and shout out your name for us? Adrian. Can you do it again because of the wind? Let the wind up, calm down a little bit and shout it out again. Anything you want to tell us, mate? Shout your name out now. Right. Quick prayer for him. Hell, Father, for right in heaven, hallowed be the name. Come, thou shalt be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, we forgive those who trespass against us. And leave us not into temptation. But deliver us from evil. But now is the kingdom of power and glory forever and ever. Amen. I hope you're resting in peace, Adrian. God bless you, mate. So this is roughly where he may have died. He took his own life by taking an overdose of medication and drink, alcohol. Apparently he dragged himself over to this area. Could be here, could be a little bit further on, I don't know, and just perished. So for some reason EVP paused. Was I in the right area, Adrian? Can you say yes or no? Okay Adrian, I'll come back another time, yeah? We're just having a little walk around today. Thank you for speaking to us. Speak to you later, mate. think I'm moving things on there, but it's just too, you know, too much wind. So I'm going to quickly check my head cam. Make sure it's still recording, guys. So hard to find. Do this one off. I've only got one pair of vans. Put this one on the floor for a minute. Yeah, still recording. For those who are going to complain about the stabilisation, I can't do nothing about the camera holder. It's got no stabilisation on the handycam. The head cam may have. I think it has, I think it's been set, I don't know. And I don't really give a shit, to be honest with you. It's too cold to start fucking around with head cams. Head over towards well, as you hear, mate. Alright, camcorder went offline. I'm at George Bidder's. Again, George Parker Bidder OC erected. By public subscription in remembrance of his effort to preserve his common, 1896. Are they looking after your common properly, George? What do you feel about all these trees being cut down? Is it pissing you off? Like it has with Leonard. I can leave ditches there. Kind of dangerous. Wish they filled them in instead of cutting trees down. I might just say it. Heading over to the homeless tree now. And then one quick half walk around the lake, and then up the hill, and then down the hill, and then home. Because I've kept my word that I'll come over. Although I did say I'd come over Monday, and it's now Sunday. Did get an old coin for the higher one in a little while. Well, I have been warned to be careful communicating with the higher one, because he is a bad type of dude. It's a high-end hanging tree. It's some Kazumi over here on this. Why is there a bag of leaves there? My gator just went crazy then. Let's dig a coin out. I always leave a coin here. Don't ask me why, but I do. I suppose there's a token of respect for the Heineken, I suppose. They had to make money somehow, didn't they? Right, so this is where I'm putting the coin. Just there. And I'm covering it up. I know there should be some coins here still. Oh, I've got my marker gone. I don't know. There's 10p coin there. The highwayman here. Someone's taking photos. Well, it's another way of taking photography. No one would take too long. It could be spiritual. Well, I don't know what's happening to this camcorder, guys. It keeps either turning off or going into standby mode. That guy's taking photos.